Why, hello there. In this video, we'll be discussing what a spectrum analyzer is and the different measurements you can make on it. My name is...
What the? Who can turn it off the light? What? Dead cat?
What's up, everyone? The name is Nick Ben, and I'm an engineer here at Keysight. And welcome to this episode of What the RF. In this episode, we'll be discussing what a spectrum or signal analyzer is. What is a spectrum analyzer, you may ask? This, right here, is a spectrum analyzer. A spectrum analyzer basically analyzes spectra. All right, fine. There's more to a spectrum analyzer than I actually let on. If you've ever used an oscilloscope, like the one that you see right here, then you know that the displays receive signals with respect to amplitude versus time. Now, on the other hand, a spectrum analyzer displays received signals with respect to amplitude versus frequency. Now, in terms of a simple analogy for this very complicated electromagnetic topic, I guess you could say it's pretty much like comparing the same data between a pie chart and a bar graph. Here, we see that Daniel has eaten 8 pies, Nick has eaten 2 pies, and Allie has eaten 1 pie. And also here, we see that Daniel has eaten majority of the pies. This can only mean that Daniel really likes pies. For those of you that don't know, the terms spectrum analyzer and signal analyzer are used almost interchangeably, but there are some slight differences. Spectrum analyzers display a signal's amplitude as it varies by frequency, but by definition, a spectrum analyzer does not measure the phase of your signal. Now, without this phase information of your signal, we wouldn't be able to measure, for example, digital communications like LTE on your cell phone. On the contrary, a signal analyzer like this one measures the amplitude and phase of a signal at a single frequency. If you transmit an RF signal from your device, a signal analyzer can downconvert the signal into a digital signal, and the signal analyzer can display the signal in terms of constellations, spectrum, power versus time, etc. Basically, a signal analyzer can measure both amplitude and frequency and phase of your signal of interest, which you can't do on a spectrum analyzer. Now let's learn what kind of measurements we can make on our all-knowing signal analyzer. The main use of a signal analyzer is to measure the power of a signal's various frequency components, like radio frequency and audio signals. A signal analyzer allows you to analyze your device's signal and circuit performance in a way that isn't possible using other means. Say, looking at it in the time domain. Spectrum and signal analyzers can make a large variety of measurements, ranging from harmonic distortion tests for transmitters, WLAN analysis, and spectral masks for showing limits of unwanted emissions, to two-tone tests on an RF power amplifier. Because of how powerful a tool a signal analyzer is, it is practically owned across all engineering labs for design development and testing of engineers' devices. If you need to see the frequency makeup of your signals, a signal analyzer is a great tool to have. Also, if you'd like to dig deeper into spectrum analysis, check out the application note in the description below. But more importantly, don't forget to subscribe and check out the other videos on our channel. All right, that's it for this episode. Thank you so much.
What the heck? Who keeps turning off the light?
Hello? Hello? What the RF? If you would tell me I'm the only one that you love, life could be a dream, sweetheart.